go.
I went outside, Eddie, last week when the wind was blowing, the garbage, my garbage can blew down on the road. And I went out to pick it up, and as I'm picking it up, it blew again, and the lid, I swear to God, hit me straight in the face.
The wind was furious today.
Yeah, it was one day last week, you're right. My phone off here, this vibrate shit.
All right, welcome. Where is everybody tonight?
Very quiet.
No ridge line, no one comes.
We gotta do that every weekend.
All right, Kyle.
Okay, the meeting tonight is for the Upton Town Business by the Town Board. The public is invited to participate in the items marked on the agenda for public comment. During that segment of the meeting, if you have a question or comment for the supervisor, please raise your hand, you need to be acknowledged. Please state your full name and limit your remarks to 3 minutes. Thank you for your participative cooperation.
Thank you. March 11th, 2024 meeting of Town of Marlborough, and please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And please remain standing for a moment of silence for all the men and women who sacrificed their lives to allow us to serve our country and our town. Thank you.
Okay. I need a motion to approve the agenda.
I'll make the motion to approve the agenda.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So moved. Motion to approve the minutes. Motion to approve the minutes from the February 26, 2024 Town Board meeting. I'm going to go through them all. This is A, that's the regular Town Board meeting, and B, motion to approve the minutes from the February 26, 2024 public hearing on the local law, Town of Marlborough, Ulster County, New York, amendment Chapter 155 zoning, supplement. Regulations governing certain uses, Section 155-31, site plan review of the Marlborough Town Code, and C, motion to approve the minutes from the February 26, 2024 public hearing local law of the Town of Marlborough, Ulster County, New York, amending various provisions of Chapter 155 zoning of the Marlborough Town Code as follows, amending Section 155-1, adding definitions for cannabis, cannabis establishment, cannabis on-site consumption establishment, cannabis products and cannabis retail dispensary, Section 155-12, use regulations, and adding Section 155-32.5, cannabis marijuana retail sales and lounges. And D, motion to approve the minutes from the February 26, 2024 public hearing local law of the zoning Town of Marlborough, Ulster County, New York, amending Chapter 155 zoning article IX administration enforcement, Section 155-41.1, ridgeline and sleep slope protection of the Marlborough Town Code. So I need a motion to approve all the minutes for A, B, C, and D.
I will make the motion to approve all the minutes as listed in items A, B, C, and D.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Yes. Thank you, Eddie. So moved then. Authorize the payment of bills in the amount of $551,142.31. I need a motion to pay the bills.
I make a motion to authorize the payment of bills of $551,142.32.
31 cents.
35 cents.
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So moved. Thank you. Any comments on the agenda? On the agenda specifically? Yes. What does she have on here?
Well, she takes them all off now because we don't do them.
And boards.
No, that's not you. You would be committee.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, this is all just our departments and our boards. Yep. Any other comments on the agenda?
You put that to the second meeting.
Okay, and reports of department and boards. Does anybody have any questions on all our department and board? I have them all here. So if anybody on the board has a question, if not, as we stated before, these are all online. They'll be online starting tomorrow if the public wants to see them. But if the board doesn't have any questions, we're going to move past them. Presentations. So see, if everybody came tonight, I have a short little presentation because everybody's asking me about what Tomback looks like inside. So, well, I signed out. Let me know. I got to sign all the way back in. Oh, my God. Not too much. Okay. So everybody knows what the outside looks like now, right? As you go by 100 times in the last 2 months. So the outside's looking great. It's pretty much done. Myself, Councilman Zambito, Superintendent Alangi, Gary Lazaroff, Charlie, everybody came up, and Mike Scatoro, we came up with a plan to do the outside. So Dave, like, we're going to probably start doing that, and then, you know, probably by the end of the month into the next month, right? That's the last phase of what we have to complete. There's a lot of work to go on the outside. We're going to have a resolution tonight for the blacktop, and you could see this is what the porch looks like underneath. If you didn't get close, we have really nice lights. It's a cathedral roof. We have the auto opener down here for handicap accessibility. These are some of the interior windowsills where we got material from Sam over at Maple Tree Discounted. Here's Deputy Supervisor Appler and Dave, who built the serving area in the community room using the rock. This was the office space that we built. This was when it was sheetrock. Then obviously we started painting. And this is kind of what it looks like now. We could have conferences in there. These were the bathrooms as they were going on, the tile work that was going in the bathrooms. This is some of the finished tile work as of now in the bathrooms. We stuck with a gray theme in there. This is the hallway. We stuck with the same tile going out into the hallway. This is between the community center and the rec center side. So there's a hallway with a water fountain, which is required by code. Exit signs required by code. Hand dryers, the fixtures are going in now. The slop sink's going in. The sinks are going in. This was the community room as it was being built. This was the addition. All the tiles going in, the floor, the HVAC. This was the other serving table. This is on the community side room. This is the pass-through with the matching doors. This is the server room as it was starting to get set up. This is the kitchen. As you can see, the kitchen is pretty much almost all done. This is when it was getting tiled. This is all the fixtures. There's a dishwasher, sink, stove, hood, freezer, refrigerator. Everything's in there. So here's the community room as the floor was going down. It's painted now. We got the speakers in the ceiling, all the audio visuals up. Here's the room pretty much completed. As you can see, it's a pretty big room. The community room is 35 by 65 long, plus it has the garage area, which is the additional space. I think, Tom, you said you could fit well over 200 people in here, yeah, in this room. Probably more if it was just standing. And this is the serving area that Gail built. We have the speakers up here. We have the projector. There's a projector screen right here that lowers down from the ceiling. All the emergency exit doors, all the emergency lights, all the fire detection systems. There's cameras in the ceiling. There's cameras throughout the whole building, so we could watch everything anybody's doing. So this is what we're going to be doing outside. You can see where the guy's been cleaning up. This is like my kind of just drawing. Don't hold me to it. I just drew this. But this is what we're looking at doing tonight. So we're extending. This is why we're hammering out this rock. We're extending it and squaring off the parking lot. As you can see before, it came down as like a weird angle on the parking lot. Now it's going to get squared off. It's going to go 20 feet this way into the grass to make additional parking. We're going to try to make it as a wraparound, like you see the arrows, so you could get the most parking out of it. It's also going to wrap around to the front of the building on the side. And then I'll show you in the next screen on this side, there's going to be two handicap spots up front, parking here, more handicap here, because on the back, we're going to be pouring, this is the work we got to do. There's going to be another handicap accessible ramp here that comes out this way. There's going to be stairs going down this way. We're going to have block that goes around the whole perimeter like this, so we don't hit any kind of our equipment. There's going to be a stairway here coming out. Then there's going to be block that goes around the building like this for a planter bed, and it extends up to here. It's going to come around this way. So this will all be planter bed, and this way it will have a stoppage so cars don't go into the building. So, and this is all part of the blacktopping that's going to be done from tonight's approval.
So is the painting and the lines of the parking lines, it's all included with that price?
No, not the lines, so just the blacktop. Just a blacktop.
Okay.
But he does do lines, so I have to get that. So this is what we're working on, right, Sherrida and Tom? I just kind of like threw some, but we're going to be putting in lights here. This is Young's Field. And I want to thank the chief and Officer Griggs for getting these. These are our aerial shots by our drone that we have at the police department. So they did a pretty good job. But this is kind of where we want to put lights that are going to be shining on the field. Now, again, don't hold me to where the spots are because that's been designed. But you could see in the next picture, the guys have been up there last week and they've been fixing this drain problem that we have. They widened this. They doubled the size of the width of this drain. And I think everybody might have went up there this weekend. You notice we didn't have any real flooding on the field. Because we're getting good flow, not only there, but over here mainly. This is where the most flooding comes from because there was a curb right over here, which you don't see. And they widened that by like three times the amount.
Yeah,
so it was coming over the curb, and then it was coming over here and coming straight this way.
You need to send me these pictures. Those infields are looking not very round.
No. But now that you see the fields, yeah, the fields got to be actually fixed a little, right?
Yeah.
So that's just some of the stuff that we've been doing over the last week. But like I said, the community center is looking good inside. So hopefully another month or so, 2 months, because we got to do the outside.
September?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
By September?
For the community center?
Right now, they're planning on blacktopping hopefully in May. So after the blacktop's done in May,
Scott.
I would say by June, I would hope by June. I mean, we got to make sure everything's working right and everything's done right, but we got to make sure that these guys can fit it into their schedule. The highway guys, obviously, it's a busy time of the year too, so there's a lot of moving parts, so they're doing it as they can, you know, spare hours here or there, right? I'm hoping.
Just in time with the pickleball courts
right
too, right?
For the pickleball courts I've been working on, that's been all measured out. I had a call over to Tilcon. They're going to be donating all the rock we're going to make the parking lot at Young's a little bigger, and we're going to gravel that. We're going to make the parking lot, obviously, at Community Center bigger, and so they're going to be donating all that material to us. So there's a lot of things we're doing other than the ridge lot. So, you know, we got a lot of stuff on our plate, and it's all coming to a head right now. Of course, we're doing the whole Milton Landing over right now. So that's already started. The pier work, he's coming. He's going to start next month also, replacing the pier that caught on fire. So there's going to be a lot of work being done at the Milton Landing. That means we can't rent out the train station for quite a while here until all that work is done. So we've told the clerk's office to hold off at least 2 months for now at the community center. At the train station for rentals. Also meeting with Central Hudson again to move some lights and poles down there at the Milton Landing. Met with our engineering at Old Indian Trail this past week. I think we came up with a possible solution, but we'll see. So there could be a solution. This Central Hudson's got to be part of it. That's why I'm going to be meeting them on the 20th again to see if they could help us out, and then maybe we can do something there. So a lot of stuff going on. On top of that, we got the Easter hunt coming up, so my office is filled with 8,000 eggs and all kinds of snacks and goodies and all kinds of things to give out. So what day is that again? That's March 31st, right?
No, Saturday the 30th.
30th.
Yes. Scott, should we ask the rec committee to potentially plan an open house once the community center is up and running so everybody can see it?
Oh, yeah, that's definitely. We're going to have a big ribbon cutting and all that. And I would definitely want people to come up and see what the community center is all about. I just don't want to have it until it's done.
Until it's done.
And operational. So, but it looks good. Go ahead, Mick.
In terms of landscaping, I passed Young's Park and I saw that everything is totally level. So, we had discussed at the CAC opportunities to get different plantings through grants. So, I don't know if the town has any plan on replanting anything like for border around or for any shade trees or.
Well, the plant beds, Dave's going to be doing the plant beds for us, designing that for us, and we're going to do it very low.
She's talking about a Little League field.
Which field? Yeah. Oh, Little League field. I'm sorry.
There's no trees in baseball, Mickey.
Anyway, they specifically because
The Little League field, once they're all done, I'm sure there's something we can do there because, I'll pass it off to you, Sherida, because you're there more than I am now.
Yeah, no, I think that
you don't want trees near the field.
Well, not near.
Not near the field, but you're right. It wouldn't be terrible to have a little bit of shade for people watching the games. And we do, now that the stream has been cleared out there, we also are going to have a fencing situation.
It was real baseball back then. We didn't have to put trees
on. because now there's no border from the T-ball field for balls.
Yeah, I know. No, we got to put a fence up there.
Yeah.
I actually talked to the guys about putting up like a 3-foot fence, a small fence, like a little mini fence. So, because there's no nothing there for them, but maybe you can find the balls that go in the wood into the water now.
That's what they said. They're like, well, the brook is moving so fast that I don't think you're going to stop a ball that goes in the water.
Yeah, it
which is a good thing. That's an improvement. Thing, T-ball ones probably do. Yeah.
But I don't know. Do you want them to look at trees or?
I can ask. I won't speak unilaterally for everybody there, but I could certainly bring that up.
There are, the DEC and Ulster County be much better equipped to tell you what they have absolutely available, but I do know that there are plantings that can go along the brook sides that will help to stabilize the sides of those ditches, and also those that love water that would be better equipped to do that.
Sure. Yep, let me check in with the league, Mickey, and I can circle back to you.
Okay.
Perfect, thank you.
Uh-huh. All right, Tina,
what's going on?
Give me my. She didn't give me the bill. I have to look at my email. So I want to do the Callahan Industries site. State bid price for the paving of the town community center. So Callahan is the company we use when we pave all our roads. They do a state bid price. So Superintendent Longy reached out to them. They gave us a good price on it. But let me see. I send it to you guys, right?
You got it. Yeah.
I just want to make sure I say the right number. Right here, right?
Yeah.
Is this it?
Yeah. Yep.
All right, so everybody can see, this is state bid price. You can see they're going to be putting down overlay over top, 1.5 inch, and it's not cheap, as we know, but actually it's kind of cheap considering how much we're getting, $600 a ton. But the price is $69,185.13. State bid price, state labor price. And I talked to a bunch of people, they tell me that this is actually a really good price. So, again, it's the same company we use for our roads that we use throughout the year. So I just need a motion to approve.
Scott, do these guys do the painting of the lines, or we got to have to?
No, they do. They do? Will. So, I just never asked them to do it because I want to make sure we could fit everything within there. Once they get it all laid out, exact, then they come in with a machine and they measure and make sure they can fit all the spots that we want.
Right. So shouldn't we get a price from them?
Oh, I will, but he won't do it till it's done.
What's that?
He doesn't do it till it's done because he says, even though he estimates what we want to do, sometimes things come up during them paving, and they might not be able to make it as wide as I want or extend it as far as I want because of rock.
I understand.
And then once he does that, he'll give me a price.
Yeah, but just to get a number so we could, like, do
global
thing, and you that's your best bargaining.
Oh, I'll get it. Don't worry. He has state bid pricing.
I'm not worried.
So I'm not worried about the price because this guy's got the best price. That's why we use him every year. So, and again, he's given a state bid price. So it's not like he's lowballing any lower than he can. He's giving you exactly what the state allows by state bid. So that's why we use them. But yeah, definitely. But I just need a motion to approve the parking lot paving for the community center. Again, this is for the whole back area, the extension of the back area, the front area, wrapping around to the handicap area, and up to the road. And at $69,185.13. I just need a motion.
I'll make the motion to approve the blacktop for the parking lot of $69,000 by Calicanon.
I need a second.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Anybody opposed? So moved. Thank you. All right. No, I'll definitely get it, Manny. I was just more concerned about the blacktop right now.
No, I get it.
Let's see. Anybody? I got a couple correspondence. One's from Sheriff. I got... Dear Mr. Corcoran, with your permission, the Marlborough United Soccer Club would like to request the use of the lower round pond, Clewitt Soccer Field, at no cost for the spring 2024 recreational youth soccer program. Saturdays in April through June, 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. The specific dates are 4/27, 5/4, 5/11, 5/18, 5/25, and 6/1. Regarding insurance, we are a member of the East Hudson Youth Soccer League and will be providing through the league for the field and players. It is currently on file with the town clerk. Thank you for your time. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. Regards, Dina Mincer, Marlborough United Soccer Club. Now these dates, Kyle, don't coincide with anything. Well, it doesn't have anything to do with you guys, but.
Now they gave you a new certificate of insurance this year.
What about the, doesn't have a conflict with the senior picnic or anything like that, right?
No, senior
picnic,
that's late. June 1st,
The only thing I would also say, we told them last year, is they got to make sure if they're taking their kids in, the kids are going to the bathroom, someone's got to escort these kids into the bathroom, in and out, because we had the problem with they broke the fixtures the previous year. So,
yeah, we're not positive.
Well, we don't know, but it was a time that they were at the park. So we just want to make sure that there's escorts into the bathroom.
And also the garbage.
And the garbage, correct. Yep.
We'll reiterate it, but we have spoken to them and said there's any...
Garbage shouldn't just be left all over the ground, and it should be put into the garbage. And if they can, bring the garbage bags over to the big garbage can. So Marlborough Youth does a pretty good job when they're up there, so I expect the soccer league to do the same. So I need a motion to waive the fees for the 2024 recreational youth soccer program through Marlborough United Soccer Club at the Cluett-Shantz Park.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, thank you. And here's one, dear Mr. Corcoran and board, I have appreciated the opportunity to work in the assessor's office as data collector for the past 2 years. Unfortunately, due to diagnosis in April 2023 of a spinal fracture, two broad-based bulging discs, and severe orthoporosis,
Osteoporosis.
Okay, there we go. I am unable to continue in the position. I was unable to work from March 13, 2023 until I returned in October 2023 to complete the paperwork associated with my data collection in 2022. And it's first week of March 2023. My physician has advised me that it would not be advisable for me to continue in the position due to danger of falling in the field work aspect in the position due to the fact that my flexibility has been diminished due to the disc issue. It's been a pleasure to work with everyone in town hall, and I'm sorry to have to leave. Sincerely, Judy Pisa. So Judy has been doing our assessment throughout the town as we're trying to get our assessments all up to date. She did an awesome job, but as you could tell, she has issues with her back, and it's been very difficult for her. So sad to see her go, but it's the best for her. So thanks to Judy for all her work. So thank you. We'll be looking for someone else again. We can't keep that position, it seems like. So anyway, anybody got any public comments? Any public comments? No more public comments. We're going to go on the resolutions. Resolution 33. On this one here, is this the one Danielle asked me to amend? Hold on a second. They want us to add, oh yeah, on this one, not the 33. Okay, 33 is good. Resolution 33, to advertise for highway items. Supervisor Corcoran proposes the following. Resolved that the town board authorize the town clerk to advertise for the following highway materials. Item number one, road materials, washed stone, 3/4 inch stone. Item four, delivered per New York State specs. Item two, material hauling specs available at the town clerk's office. Now therefore, be resolved the town board authorize the town clerk to place a legal notice in the official newspaper for the town requesting sealed bids on highway items, and that all bids must be accompanied by a signed non-collusive affidavit, and be it further resolved that all bids be received by the office of the town clerk, 21 Milton Turnpike, Milton, New York, 12547, until 2 p.m., April 15, 2024, at which time they will be opened and read aloud, and moves for its adoption.
Yes.
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 Yes. Now, resolution 34, we got to make an amendment for an item number three, and that's gasoline. Let me get her note up. I'm sorry. I just want to make sure I get the right thing here. But we need it as a backup in case the school, God forbid, doesn't come through, which happened a couple times. So we just get a price, doesn't mean we're ever going to use them, but it's just a backup.
You read my mind.
Let me see here. Danielle, where are you, Danielle? Okay. I thought she would have had this here. Tina took off today, so this is why this is like this.
Tina can't leave you unattended, huh?
No. All right.
I saw it too.
So I need to amend resolution 34 to add number three, number four, and number five, and number six as listed here, which would be unleaded gasoline regular 87 octane, unleaded gasoline mid-grade 89 octane, unleaded gasoline premium 93 octane, and diesel ultra-low sulfur. So I need a motion to add those four items to our...
I'll make the motion to add those items to resolution number 34.
Okay. I need a second.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 So resolution 34, as amended to advertise for fuel items, Supervisor Cork proposes the following. Resolve the town board authorize the town clerk to advertise for the following items. Item number one, propane. Item number two, heating fuel. Item number three, unleaded gasoline, regular 87 octane. Item number four, unleaded gasoline, mid-range 89 octane. Item number five, unleaded gasoline, premium 93 octane. Item number six, diesel ultra-low sulfur. Now, therefore, be resolved, the town board authorize the town clerk to place a legal notice in the official newspaper for the town requesting sealed bids for fuel items, that all bids must be accompanied by a signed non-collusive affidavit, and be it further resolved that all bids be received by the office of the town clerk, 21 Milton Turnpike, Milton, New York, 12547, until 2 p.m. April 15th, 2024, at which time they will be opened and read aloud. It moves for its adoption.
Yes.
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 Yes. Thank you. Resolution 35, to make 2023 budget amendments. And this should close out the 2023 year. These are all the budget transfers for accounting purposes when we move one item to another line item within our budget or within our building funds or our park funds. And Resolution 35, to make 23 budget amendments, Supervisor Corcoran proposes the following. Be it resolved, the town board of the town of Marlborough approves the attached 2023 budget amendments, and these are all the line items. It's all for our accounting. They all equal out. I know you guys had this. And they all equal out $497,330. So you guys got any questions on any of the transfers? If not, moves for its adoption.
Yes.
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 Yes. Thank you. Resolution 36. Did I just do this one? Oh, this is a tri-way. Supervisor Cork proposes the following. Whereas the town board needs to approve the transfer of funds, be it resolved the following transfer, $64,701 from the park reserve fund to the general fund for highway department work at the town park in 2023. And she didn't have the breakdown. And moves for its adoption. This is all the work that the highway department did at our town park in the last year. And the monies did come out of the town park fund for recreation. So this is the number, $64,701. And moves for its adoption.
Yes.
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 Yes. Resolution 37, to adopt a useful life schedule. And this is what we have to do every year if things change. This is useful life of our different items that we have at the highway department, our building department, different things that we have on the for insurance purposes. They have to tell the insurance company what the useful life is. And this is an update to it. So Supervisor Cork proposes the following. Whereas fixed assets are non-current assets that have a useful life over 1 year, and whereas fixed assets are depreciated over their useful life, and whereas on March 13, 2023, the town board of town of Marlborough adopted a useful life schedule, be resolved that the fixed asset useful life schedule be amended to include heavy equipment and attachments, and be resolved to amend the useful life schedule for snow plows, spreader sanders, mowers, trailers, from 15 years to 10 years, and be it further resolved, the town board of the town of Marlborough hereby adopt the attached adopted schedule for the fixed assets. So this is all the different things like our computers, our cameras, our live scan.
So
pumps.
Scott, the only thing that's changing on the list is the addition of heavy equipment and attachments at the bottom, and then
these highlighted
snow plow
things.
Decrease.
Yep, the snow plow, the spreaders going to 10. The mower, the trailer, and the heavy equipment.
Gotcha. Yeah. So everything highlighted.
Everything else stays as is. Those were the updates.
Okay.
And moves for its adoption.
Yes.
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 Yes. Eddie, look at this. It's your time of the night already.
Really? It's my turn?
It's your turn, Ed. Manny stepped in for your last meeting, just so
thanks,
you know.
Manny. Looking at this. 7:35, I move for an adjournment.
I need a second.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So moved.
Thank you.